There is the town. And see the little
Cool.
people? They're yellow, they're blue. So over here, you have this panel that's showing the number of infected. They're red. And it's over time. You can see the moon come up, the sun come up. So it's their days over time. You can see, you can change over here the defaults. So if you don't quarantine people, then you can look at the infection rate, which is the red line over here. You can do percent vaccinated. You can increase that. Infection rate should go down and things like that. And so this is the model. This is like the face of the model that they develop. And they use social forces models and other epidemiological tools to come up with what would really happen given real-time, sort of real-time data, ground truth data in a town. You can see there's a school, there's a library, there's a grocery store, the hospital. But you could envision this being your campus, and this is what you would see. Or this could be your school grounds. You're at a high school, and you could see what would happen if people go about their daily business. And let's say they are not mask compliant at all. You take away a mask, no one's wearing a mask. And then you can look over here and you can see what happens to the infection rate, hospitalizations, death rates, and so forth. And these are the number of days passed.
And
So the
that's even with a high percentage of vaccinated. So the percentage of vaccinated is high, but mass compliance is down.
So that's a good point. I'm glad you noticed that because I think they just put in the model these variants. And one thing about the variants is they are more contagious. And so these behaviors that you do, even getting vaccinated, doesn't give you 90% protection. You know, it starts dropping to like 70%, in some cases 50%, if you don't wear masks. So all these things go together. So you know, without wearing a mask, being vaccinated, but then being exposed to Omicron, that's a different story.